dollar, only wanna get the job done. I don't know a nigga that could cover for me. Yeah, got some game from my days. So she might say she love me, she don't love me like she say she love me. Believe me.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy. Boy, believe me. Love this song. All right. Welcome to Fat Boy Fragrance. Of course, I'm Mr. Fat Boy, the one and only freestyle king of this fragrance game. No edits, no do-overs. Man, the hardest working man in this fragrance game. One video every day. If I miss one, I do two the next day. I bring it every time for y'all. Thank you so much. If you're new to my channel, come on in, baby. Hit that like and subscribe. Yeah, it's like this every time you come in. And you a VIP guest. Pull up a seat. I'll take care of you. Show some positivity, some love, and bring you some energy every time. Because I get the job done, baby. I don't need nobody to cover for me. Thank you so much for all the love. Man, we are having a crazy, crazy, I mean crazy month. The numbers are through the roof. And numbers ain't everything. But as you know, we got the road to 1,500. We're going to get there by next month. Y'all get ready to see those prizes coming, baby. Details below on what you can win. You must be a subscriber and leave a comment on the video, and you're entered every time you leave a comment on the video. That's it. The more comments you leave on each video, per video, better your chances, baby. Woo! Thank y'all again. Like I said, this is growing organically, naturally. We doing it the right way. We ain't riding no coattails. We ain't trying to get all up in other stuff. We are doing it our way. I'm doing it my way. And I've stuck to my guns. No freebies, no nothing. I pay for everything. And I only can do it that way. And I appreciate y'all understanding that and appreciating that and showing the love. All right, y'all ready? We are going to review today Business Over Pleasure, baby. A little bit of, let's find out what this one's all about. I kind of a little bit first impression, but I wanted to wear it and give you my full feelings on it. Somebody asked me which one I like better, and I was like, man, I don't know yet. I got to give them all good wear before I tell you the truth, to be fair to these people, because they put in the work, and it's time for me to respect that work. All right, let's get all up in this review today of Business Over Pleasure. And you know how we do it, baby. No edits, no do-overs. All we need is one take, and one take, and we get it right. Fat Boy Fragrance Review starts now. Are we back, baby? Y'all ready to get all up in this review? All right, let's do this. Here we go. Where's the box? And where's, there we go. Once again, here's the presentation again. Business Over Pleasure. There you go. You got Ross Carlos and George Sirhoff in the bottom. Briefly, real quick, if you're not familiar with George Sirhoff, I can understand that. I got into this review game about 10 months ago, 11 months ago, and I didn't know who George was. And I've been collecting fragrance for a long time. So George Sirhoff is a, I don't know what you call him. He's an entrepreneur. A perfumer for sure. He owns his own perfume brand, and it's called Zoroff. He has several in there. Of the newest ones he's had, and his signature one, you have Signature Zoroff Signature. Really nice barbershop fougere grown man fragrance right here. You have Signature Noir. Kind of a youthful take on the original Signature. And then you have Signature Royale, which is probably my favorite. It's a well-done fragrance. Of course, this new one, which I plan to review tomorrow night on my other primetime video. Because I'm going to do all George's in primetime. Show it the respect it deserves. And that's Rosé. All right? So, of course, we have the other two content creator stuff, but right now we're just going to talk about this one. Ross Carlos has a channel called TLTG TV Reviews. I'll leave the link below. He has a lot of subscribers. He hasn't been doing it forever. If you like, you know, like fragrance haul videos or like, you know, cheapy finds, you know, cheapy rack store stuff, just the basic, you know, there's nothing really like groundbreaking or superbly different about what Ross does. It's polished, it's done well, and it's informative. That's it. All right, so moving on to the fragrance. So George partnered with these three people. Curly Scents. Let me get that right this time. Jesus. I didn't know there was two Curlys in the fragrance universe. Curly Scents and Justin. I don't know his last name. Then they have their fragrance too, which I will review too. I don't subscribe to none of their channels. It's not my style. I don't need channels about finding rack store bargains because I don't shop in rack stores that much. I'm more of an internet shopper when it comes to this kind of stuff. When I go into the rack store, I never find nothing. So it's just not my style. And I don't really watch a lot of the bigger ones because they don't really give me anything I don't already know. Now, when you get down to, when you get to smaller channels, you find out stuff that you didn't know. And it's informative. And sometimes you just want to be, just, you know, support the smaller channels. So I support the smaller channels, absolutely. I will never turn my back on those on those people, man. And if you are a small time sub right now, and I'm still small time, but if you're just getting started and you need help, just reach out to your boy. I'll leave my email in the description. You can reach out, and if you have any questions, because I remember when I tried reaching out to some people that were bigger timers, none of them ever hit me back. And I didn't forget that. And I still know who everyone your names are. So when I pass you, I'll let you know. That's another whole story. I'm not going to get negative. Okay, here we go. All right. TLTG Reviews Business Over Pleasure. Here's the bottle. What you know about that Spice One? You know, I miss Spice One's music, man. Golly. So, TLG TV, here's the box. It's got that nice hologram etching on the back. The presentation, listen, George is not going to put out a fragrance that does not look right, period. So we know that already. All right, so let's put the box down. It's just like the rest of his bottles, the same style, same cap. It's not, it's plastic, but it's a solid plastic. And then there is the bottle there on the back. He's the only one that has this etching on there. I feel like this one has more surface stuff. It's more about the surface with this one. It's more flashy, eye-catching, trying to get your attention more. And I can see why. From just the community's comments and stuff, this is the one that nobody was really couldn't figure out why this was happening. But you gotta give credit. The bottle looks gorgeous. I love the etching on the back. Super cool. All right, so let's go ahead and pull up the notes in this bad boy, and we'll put the skin, and I'll revisit it, and I'll give you my feelings on it, and see if it gets the fat boy seal of approval all the way, halfway, or no way. All right, here we go. In the top, this is an Eau de Parfum concentrate. You have Szechuan pepper, bergamot, coriander. And in the middle, you have lemon verbena. I love lemon verbena. Lily of the Valley, cashmere wood, Florentine iris, ginger. And in the bottom, you have Gaiac wood, Palo Santo, tonka, musk, patchouli, and amber. Now, George goes out of his way to make sure these ingredients are on point, and he takes hands-on with that. I mean, I can't say enough about the quality of George, what he does, period. He said, basically, this fragrance was like, say, Signature Noir, which is a youthful, playful take on Signature. Still got that fougere vibe, but it's toned down, and the bergamot and the citrus is amped up on it. Take that and give it, and add it to this and give it a more fresher take. So, let's put it in the skin. Let's see what we get in real time, and I'll give you my opinion. Here we go. off the jump, all I get is signature. This one is a lot like Signature Noir. Of all three of these, this one's more like Signature Noir. I mean, Signature or Signature Noir is definitely in that vein. Where it starts to differentiate itself is in the start right after the initial spray, about, I say, 30 seconds later, you get this powderiness. You get this citrusy, musky vibe to it. What that means is a little bit more mass appealing. So, starts off with Noir, which is, you know, George's fragrances aren't for everybody. Don't get me wrong. My wife doesn't like most of them. She's not into that kind of style of fragrance. And they're not mass appealing. Don't get me wrong. George's fragrances is not like, you know, a mass appealing niche fragrance. It's not. It's definitely for guys. It's definitely a certain mold of a guy. You'll never have people talk bad about it because they love George. It's the way it is. And when you're that good of a person to everybody, people will have a hard time talking bad about you regardless. But it don't matter. His stuff is great. All his fragrances are great. Where this one is basically one of his fragrances freshened up. That's it. So take Signature Noir, make it a little bit fresher, more mass appealing, a little bit crisper, a little bit lighter, and that's what you get. I don't get a lot of the pepper in there, a little bit of the pepper on the back end right there. It's not that bad. But I do get a good bit of that ginger, which I do like. And I do like the fact that the tonka and the musk are in there with some amber in the end. That gives a little bit more sweetness, makes it a little bit easier to dry down, gets away from the fougere a little bit, becomes more of an ambery, sweeter vibe towards the end of this fragrance. So yeah, but what you're getting basically is noir, freshened up and sweetened up a little bit. Is that a bad thing? No. Is it a groundbreaking break the wheel? No, but for $119, that's priced right. Yeah, it turns into a really nice fragrance. It's just like, it's funny because I feel like it's, they mislead you a little bit. You know, it's like, hey, it's noir for a second. Then you get, whoa, wait a minute, what's this underneath noir? Very pleasing. I think an easy fragrance to wear to any occasion. Dress it up, dress it down. You can wear this at any time. I would say winter, fall, summer, anytime. It's a year-round fragrance. It's built for any situation, dress up, dress down. Is it a fragrance you can spray right away and walk in? Maybe not. Give it about 5 minutes, at least, before you got to go in somewhere. I think it's when it really starts to find itself. All right, let's see if it gets the Fat Boy Seal approval all the way, no way, halfway, or all the way, baby. Now, here's the deal. I will have a video and bring them all back at the end when I review all three of them. And I'll pick my favorite of them. Then I'll let you know my favorite is. All right, so performance. That's where it lacks. It's a skin scent after about an hour, and I can't smell much of it after about, say, 2-3 hours. So performance is severely lacking on this one. But for me, performance is not a huge deal. I'll carry a decant. But if that's a big deal to you, then you might not think this is performance well enough. But for $119 and these quality fragrance, it should perform a little bit better, being an eau de parfum concentrate. But I think when you lighten this one up and you add some ingredients that are not going to have staying power, that's what happens. All right, does the wifey like it? She didn't really like it. She didn't hate it. It was okay. I did not get any compliments wearing it. I can understand. This fragrance is a nice fragrance. But I wore it for a day to work and a half a day after that and just didn't catch any vibes. Asked a couple people what they thought, but the smell instead smelled okay. All right, and do I like it? So, performance doesn't perform well. It hasn't got me a lot of compliments. It starts off, hold on guys, my light gave out on me. That's all right, there we go. It starts off as a nice fragrance, but what happens is it just doesn't last long. And I'm going to keep this video going because you know me, I ain't do no edits. I got one ready to go right here. I was ready for this, so hold on 1 second, baby. You know your boy don't do no edits. No is, baby. I got you. I get in there. All right. There it goes. Sorry about that. That's very, very... Sorry about that, guys. Happens, it happens. Okay. My seal approval... I'm going to say about 75%. Because, A, it is a nice fragrance. But it doesn't perform at all. And I don't know if it's going to be pleasing for compliments or not. Let me pick up my speaker. My speaker fell. So, that's it. I would say I recommend you sample this one first or try the other ones before you try this one. If you're a person who likes that, likes Noir or Signature or any of those, but want a fresher take on it and a more light take on it, a little bit sweeter take on it, there you go. That will be for you. Me, I prefer the what Noir and all them are. I like that. If I want a fresher fragrance, I go for something else. So that's kind of the way I feel about it. I wear this maybe once or twice a year. Maybe it won't be something I'll reach for all the time. These are available for sampling. All of them are on the FatboyFragrance.com and Fatboy Frags on eBay. Support your boy. That's it. So those are my real feelings on it. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Sorry about the light situation. My bad. But y'all stay safe and y'all stay well. And let's let Bushwick take us out, baby. You feel good, baby. And you smell good, baby. Baby, it's going to be all good. Fatboy Fragrance Reviews is out.